want to know the hottest show, where you can come and get the tea. She's got everything you want. Tune in now so you can see. It's Averianna.
Nashville, what is up? We done made it. Welcome back to another episode of the What's a Cashville podcast. You know it's where everyone has a voice. I am your host, Averianna, the personality, and happy Sunday. Happy October. Happy fourth quarter, okay? Y'all, it's go time. It's that season. It's October 1st, so I'm super excited to be, you know what I'm saying, spend a little time with you on this Sunday fun day. But before we get into anything, you know we gotta give God at least 10 seconds of moment of silence to thank Him for waking us up this morning and everything He do all day, every day. So here we are. All right, y'all, today is another fun one. Let's take a look at this weather in the Music City. Kicking it off this week today, it is currently 80 degrees. We have a high of 80. And a low of 61. And let's take a look at this weather for the week. Y'all see it. The weather is definitely dropping. You know, we're stepping into this fall season. Sunday, the high 87. Monday, high 87. Tuesday, 84. Wednesday, 82. Tuesday, 83. Friday, 81. And Saturday, it's only 79. So the lowest temperature we're seeing right now is about 57. You know what I'm saying? So like I said, we're stepping into this fall season. So make sure you dress accordingly. And if it's up to me, I'ma just say, go ahead and switch clothes out. It's that time. It's out time now for all boots, shorts, and unless you're wearing boots. You know what I'm saying? Unless you got the thighs or whatever. But all the summer stuff, and I'm preaching to the choir. I'm talking to myself, but y'all get on me. Just gotta switch it on over. It's transitional season. What are we transitioning to? A new season. Hey, Lily. How did I do? All right, y'all, let's get into everything local. Right now, the Nashville International Airport has got some new visuals and some new businesses, you know, housed inside of it. Monday, they unveiled what they say is the history of Music City, told in a black and white photos in its exit hall. You can take a look at that right now. And its new international arrival facility baggage claim in the U.S. custom area. So if you're coming in, international, and go get your bag, you're gonna be able to see that black and white, you know what I'm saying, Music City Memorial. And also, y'all, I don't know if y'all seen it, but you know, black businesses is in the building. Slim and Huskies opened up their new facility within the airport, so I'm super excited. Black businesses are flourishing right here in the Music City. Make sure you go to check them out and spend a dollar, keep the dollar back, okay? What else we got going on? For you Willy Wonka lovers, you know, we're stepping into that Halloween season and, you know, holiday season. So the Dream Nashville is kicking off their cocktail factory with a Willy Wonka theme. And y'all, that is going to be going all the way until December 1st. So starting today, this Sunday, we want a Sunday fun day. We want to get a little, you know what I'm saying, get into a little camp, a little Willy Wonka vibes. Go visit the Dream and make sure you tell them you know who sent you. Okay, Music City, so let's talk sports. Now, all I'm going to say is not too much on my Titans. Now, Titans, I am just the messenger for this message, okay? Let me just read it real loud and clear. The Social said, after the loss against the Browns, the city said, y'all don't need a new stadium. Y'all need to be playing over there. And have it parked. Because what happened? I just want to understand what really happened. Can anybody DM me, let me know? Because I know your house ain't tight up. But what happened?
Tannehill sucks.
Oh my gosh, my production team is out of order. Out of order. Anywho, shout out to the Titans. Y'all know I'm always showing love to the home team. I really don't have much to say. All I got to say is what they be saying is too much money on the line to be playing. So, hey, I'm losing on this fan because y'all want to play. And I'm trying to stay on the all team. Stop playing. Stop playing with me and stop playing with my pockets, okay? Okay. That's all I got to say. Now, who else what we got coming up? Okay, today we playing the Bay Games. The Bengals, right? We playing the Bengals. Production team, since they, you know what I'm saying, they tapping in. Who y'all got on this game?
I got Titans, man.
Okay. Bengals!
I got Titans.
Okay, we got one Titans,
feel like without Joe B, we're gonna win.
I'ma say home team, we is home. It's a dub.
Tannehill gonna mess up your parlay.
It's a dub. Hey, now listen. You might wanna take a little, you know what I'm saying, a little feedback, a little advice. Cause I don't wanna mess up your pockets. But I'm gonna go ahead and go with the Titans. And then next Sunday we got the Colts. Who y'all got?
Colts.
And then they switched. Okay, I ain't really got to see the Colts play. So I'm gonna go with the home team. So two more dubs, and we'll be looking real good. We'll kind of be on schedule, is what I predicted for the beginning of the season. My dad is not here to do all that, so we good, Titans. What else? So we gotta talk about, you know, my man's prime time. We didn't get the W, obviously. That was expected. But I do want y'all to pipe down on the smack talking, because we do gotta realize what we're dealing with. They still winners. So not too much, that's all I gotta say about that, because you know I seen the look. Like, y'all already predicted who was gonna win. Who y'all predicted was gonna win? Y'all think they was gonna win?
No.
You ain't think you think you thought they were gonna win?
It was tough, man. It was tough. But
so you thought they had the potential to win?
I thought Colorado did have the potential to win, but man.
Okay.
Well, black people love hype too much.
I mean, yeah, but the thing is, support is support. It don't even matter. You know, somebody got to come out on the short end of the stick. So at the end of the day, you know, that's how the game go. You win some, you lose some. What does one say? You did. I'm done, y'all. That is the sports in Music City. Okay, y'all, let's get into these events. You know what I'm saying? Y'all always be tapping in with me on socials, texting me, emailing me, asking me, hey, ATP, what's going on in Music City? Well, here are some events that you can tap in with and tap into. And let's kick it off with tonight. We're kicking off the Cashville Cypher series. I'm super excited. Shout out to Purpose. I'm going to be hosting it, and I also have the opportunity, you know what I'm saying, to tap in with the homegrown, you know what I'm saying, it's different, and as my man Wizzle, who will be performing, said, it's going to be a little better because we did it together. Y'all, we're going to be able to check out Found Honey, we're going to be able to check out Chuck Indigo, Quez Cantrell, DH, Armand Dillard, 7 p.m., y'all, you're not going to want to miss it. Pull up on us, 970 Madison Square. I think it's about $10-$20, you know what I'm saying? Depending on what time you pull up, you know how we do, what the price is going to be. But pull up on us tonight, Cashville Cypher Series, and yeah, we would love to see you. Another date to save is Saturday, October 7th. I don't know if y'all want to say it, though, but the billboards is up, y'all. The 32nd annual Nashville Cares AIDS Walk happening at Hadley Park, October 7th. It's kicking off at 9 a.m. It's for 2 hours, y'all. 9 a.m. to 11 a.m. Come out, mix and mingle. We'll actually be able to meet our newest mayor, Freddie O'Connor. So I'm super excited to meet him. He's representing Music City. So you know what I'm saying? Hip-Hop and R&B community, I need y'all to pull up on us. Come on now. Get your voices heard. This is the Voice of Cashville podcast. You know, wherever I go, I'm trying to make sure everybody's opinions and voices are heard. So pull up on us October 7th. And also, donate. Join my team. Team ATP. Our goal is 500. I think we're at 415. So let's knock it out the park. Donate. Pull up. Commit. Cashville, Nashville community. We here. We love you. Let me see what else we got going on. Nashville's, the big goat, Delisha 2Ls, is bringing back the Nashville's October 28th for their second annual Halloween party. Who you gonna be? I'm gonna tell y'all who I'm gonna be. Okay. So let me know who y'all gonna be. Comment below. I'm excited. I always love Nashville's. They always give the feels. It is an annual event. Every time I come to the Music City, you definitely, if it's going on, you definitely want to tap in with the Nashville's. They have the hottest DJs on the ones and twos. Get your tickets now because they sell out fairly quickly every single time. And no, I can't get you no last minute tickets. I barely get in myself. Okay. So if you guys save those dates, what was that? Tonight, October 1st, October 7th, and then you have October 28th. Okay, guys, let's get into some healthy tips and affirmations. So I'm going to kick this segment off with some healthy tips. So I didn't really bring up my list for that in this segment, but I did just want to share some healthy tips that I use on regular. So typically, every week, Mondays and Tuesdays, I am juicing. I'm not eating any real tangible proteins or like hard food, candy, any of that. Everything is liquidized. So whatever I want to eat, chop it up, put it in a blender, and go on about my day. Or I just pull up to Smoothie King and get two large smoothies and, you know, obviously put one in the freezer for later. So that's just one small way just to reset your body and let all the stuff you ate on the weekend and the week before that and the week before that and the week before that, you know, just try to clear out some, give your body a break, give some a little rest, okay? So yeah, juicing Mondays and Tuesdays, it's a little healthy tip that I got for you guys. And another thing that I do is outside of those Mondays and Tuesdays, I try to only eat sides. So if I go to a fast food restaurant, if I'm sitting down eating, I only order sides, no protein. That's another easy easy way to like weed off of like eating fatty foods 24/7 just because it's there and you're hungry. Just try to, you know, choose other things on the menu outside of like the main course. And then another thing I used to do when I was really cut back was eating kids' meals. So anytime I pull up anywhere, I order a kids' meal. I don't know who it's for. Can I get a kids' meal to them? Can I get the guys some kids at the house? Can I get, hey, whatever you gotta do to play it out. But those are my healthy tips. And so hopefully those will assist you in your everyday transition into a healthy lifestyle. Let's get into these affirmations. So this week I'm doing confidence affirmations, and you know, I have been advocating lately a lot on everybody, every individual building their inner confidence so they can conquer the world in the way in which God would want us to. So I thought that I share some confidence affirmations with you guys this week in hopes of boosting their confidence. So you can hear my voice. We're going to repeat these words out louder in your head, and we're going to believe that it is so. My best doesn't have to look like anyone else's best. My best doesn't have to look like anyone else's best. I release any negative self-talk and replace it with what is true, right, and good. I release any negative self-talk and replace it with what is true, right, and good. I am grateful for my body and all that it does for me. Body, you hear me? I am grateful for my body and all that it does for me. The needs of others are just as important as mine. The needs of others are just as important as mine. I can practice self-love without feeling guilty. I can practice self-love without feeling guilty. I can allow myself to have my feelings, even the uncomfortable ones. I can allow myself to have my feelings, even the uncomfortable ones. If you said those words out loud or in your head, we're gonna believe that it is so. I'm sending y'all confidence, and I'm believing confidence boosters all up and through everybody who watching this episode, and that is the closing of our affirmations for the week. Okay, continuing on with, from our confidence affirmations, I am squeezing in a small little new segment in place of our crystals. Hopefully you guys have been blessed over the last few weeks with the crystals. But this week, I wanted to share an angel number. If you're not familiar with angel numbers are frequent repetition of numbers that pop up in your everyday life on a clock, on a receipt, on the back of a license plate, wherever you can see numbers, there you have it. Those are ways that we like to believe that God is communicating with us. So this week, angel number is 222, 222. Y'all, an angel number 222 signifies good fortune in finances, relationships, and career, as well as a reminder to work towards your soul's purpose. This number is often associated with the moon and receiving multiple sources of income. All right, now, try to tap in with what it's saying, look it up in the moment. Look it up. Whenever you see 222, look it up, because it's going to be a message divinely orchestrated for you. Strengthen your faith this week, y'all. I am in the fourth quarter, and I am big on working on my faith. You know, starving my doubt and feeding my faith, y'all. We gotta tap in a little bit more. God has required just a little bit more of us. You know what I'm saying? So strengthen that faith this week. Everything is working out for you. That is the angel number of the week, 222. Strengthen that confidence. I love y'all. Until next week, it is the What's Cashville Podcast.